Hey everybody, Devin here from American Aquarium. How you doing? Want to talk to you today about how to keep the discus fish. A lot of people think that it's hard to keep the discus fish, but if you can keep some very general basic principles in order and check, then it's actually not as hard as people make it out to be. So, and I want to say, you know, there's lots of resources out online on how to keep these fish. American Aquarium, while we've kept them, there are actually true experts in the hobby industry. And there's lots of good information, Mark Weiss being one of them. So the fish is thought to be kept at a certain pH, lower pH, between 5.0 and 6.0. When American Aquarium and others have experienced that you can actually keep this fish in higher pHs, but the goal is that you don't have a swinging pH. A swinging pH will actually cause far more damage. So keeping the discus fish at between 7.0 to 7.5 is not a problem. As long as there's no major swings, keeping a discus fish between 5.0 and 6.0 is actually a little more beneficial when you want to, say, breed the fish, but it's not required, and it's not to say that you need to keep that discus fish at 5.0 to 6.0 because that's the natural environment that they came from, like you're making a biotype aquarium. These fish are usually bred in different conditions and have adapted. And so you don't necessarily have to try to recreate a natural environment because they didn't come from the natural environment. Unless they did come from the natural environment, then it would be in their best interest. It's also thought to keep a little bit lower pH. They will have better disease resistance. American Aquarium has experienced that actually just keeping a stable pH will have good disease resistance. And then also focusing on that you provide electrolyte minerals. That's one of the key things that people end up doing for discus fish is that they will try to make softer pH waters, and then they end up stripping the water of their important mineral electrolytes. Then the fish suffers osmic regulation, and there's problems absorbing minerals back and forth between the water, and that's actually where the major damage can happen. So if you're going to use RO water or you're going to soften your water, make sure that you're replenishing the electrolytes. We suggest the AAP Wonder Shell because it sits in the water and continually dissolves. There's a benefit to that, like a constant recharge, almost like you're recharging your battery, like water is running over river rocks, same as it would into the waters they live in nature. So a constant charge is best. There's other products out there like Sea Chem Replenish, you know, but you're not getting the constant charge, but it is a step in the right direction. There's also a concept to be said about keeping a little bit lower pH waters. While it's not required, having a little bit lower pH water does take toxic ammonia and neutralizes it into ammonium, which makes it so the fish will never really have to endure or tolerate that ammonia. So if you can do a little bit lower pHs, it's just an added benefit. But like I said earlier, not required. Just making sure you have a stable pH, which is maintaining a proper KH. And if you guys need any additional information about these terms I'm throwing around, your alkalinity, if you can maintain your alkalinity, if you need help with that, see the description below. I'll throw some links in there. But maintaining your alkalinity at, say, between 3 to 5 it will actually stabilize your pH. Now, while measuring GH for your discus fish, you do want to have a little bit lower GH, but I don't want you to get confused here, because GH is where you're going to end up adding these minerals that are stripped from softer waters back in, and so you might see a little bit higher GH reading. The GH reading is not going to show you if you're actually getting an electrical charge back into the tank, which is the benefit of dosing these electrolyte minerals. But you want to make sure that you're not stripping these by having a lower GH. So shoot for a lower GH, but make sure you're dosing a constant GH supply to supply these electrolytes back into the water. And this is the same thing that would happen into the Amazon basin, where these fish are naturally found, where water is running through rocks, rivers, coming down, running over the rock, gaining an electrical charge and supplying that to the fish. It's more common, people know that you would want to keep a higher temperature for discus. Around 84 degrees is the said temperature. When you are struggling with a little bit of disease issue, you might lower that to about 79 degrees. But having a little bit warmer temperature actually helps them protect their slime coat. Recommend higher temperatures. Water maintenance is a big one for discus fish. A lot of people will say that you need to have a daily water change of about 15% to maintain no toxicity in the water. This is one way of doing it. There's also other ways of utilizing polymers to minimize nitrates, keep toxicity out of the water. And so if you're having good husbandry and maintaining the nitrates, you should not have a problem. You should have to figure out the maintenance of which way you want to do that. A lot of people will do daily water changes with their discus. If that becomes a lot of maintenance, you can consider other polymers like the Two Little Fishies NPX polymer, which will just strip nitrates, phosphates, and then you can minimize your water change schedule and keep it more for managing your GH, KH minerals, and not so much having to manage your nitrates. The discus diet is more in line with carnivore. You want to feed them shrimp, worms, a more carnivore-based, higher protein, closer to 14% protein diet. And there's the more digestible the protein, the better. Menhaden is a good example. Krill is a good example, which are better for this carnivore fish. One common myth disclaimer that has been discredited for discus fish and any fish in the hobby many times is feeding beef heart, which is said to have a high protein but is still low in digestibility, and actually it's been disclaimed as a part of the regular diet because it comes from a warm-blooded animal, and we are talking about a cooler-blooded animal. The way that beef heart fat metabolizes at these cooler temperatures will actually become more, will actually be less soluble, and so that does not pass through the fish as readily. So beef heart from a warm-blooded animal is not a good choice and has been discredited by some of the biggest names mark-wise, so I would not recommend it, but it is something that's out there as because it's an economical option for a semi-decent protein. Would not recommend it. So high protein, and then also something too is higher fiber diets. This is something that's newer in the hobby that's being explored, but it's better because it continually keeps the digestive tract clear and also feeds good bacteria in the gut where other fish foods are having to supplement probiotics. So look for a fish food that has higher fiber than 4 or 5%. You can go upwards into the double digits, 12, 15, or a little bit higher fibers. And that's best for the digestive. The thing about discus is, you know, we can give the best maintenance as possible. We can give the best care as possible. But what we need to consider is genetics. Genetics is a big player with these harder to keep fish. So definitely recommend getting your stock from a quality source. Consider going through a fish club society, making sure your local fish store is getting it from a quality stock. If you're having trouble keeping the fish and you feel like you're doing everything you can in your maintenance husbandry, consider the source you're getting it from and go through a more reputable source. That will help, and we've seen that many times as well because these fish are kept in many different conditions, and just even we know that genetics for fish, humans, any animals starts before birth, and so if there's not the best care possible from the get-go, then there could be health issues later down the road and just lead to a more sickly fish. Some behaviors that you should look out for a healthy discus fish is that this fish should actually be a really personable fish. While it could be more shy in a condition it's not familiar, once it gets comfortable, it should be a type of fish that comes to the front of the tank, is very personable, looks you in the eyes, and follows you, knows that you're its owner and that you're going to feed it. And so if these behaviors are not being exhibited, consider that there's something going on with the fish. Check your water parameters, consider if something new has been added to the tank, and just make sure everything's in check. If everything's in check and then they're still having an issue, give it a couple days, but then try to pursue what that issue may be, because the fish should be personal. They're a very personable fish. And one last thing that I forgot to mention about some really good prevention for these type of fish, considering that they are a more spendy stock, it is in best interest to get yourself a UV sterilizer. That's a more debated topic for keeping your aquariums. American Aquarium Products has done a lot of extensive research, testing, and using sterilizers on hundreds of applications, and we can tell you, not only does it get you water clarity and disease prevention, so bacterial up to viral protection, it also boosts their immunity. So it's in the best interest of the fish to have a sterilizer on the tank, and really just helps for most long-term health of the fish. Just like when you provide the electrolyte minerals, it boosts their immunity. Super important, the UVC sterilization also boosts their immunity. By keeping a lower amount, it combats the amount of acids that could affect the fish and building up in the fish and affecting the tolerance and the immunity of the fish. So definitely look at a UV sterilizer in addition to your husbandry. All right, I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye.